the Beams is an innovative new musical device. It basically consists of 6 laser beams, and each of the laser beams are tied to a musical instrument. Jerry Reipel, he's a Southwestern musician, very famous, did a lot of touring with a lot of famous bands, has his own music, but he invented the product about 14, 15 years ago, and has been on a pathway to try to commercialize it. We met him about a year and a half ago and started a relationship, and eventually led to us developing and commercializing the Beams. It's USB powered. So there's an application that runs on a computer, a laptop or a desktop, and you basically start up a playlist, and that has different genres of music. You start the music, and there's a background rhythm that plays, and as you break the individual laser beams, the instruments pick up with the rhythm in the background. Depending on the tempo and the time of interfacing with the laser beams, it changes the tone of the instrument. Well, first and foremost, we had to maintain in the arm alignment between the different lasers and sensors in the arm, to a point of about a 1 millimeter distance or tolerance between the laser and sensor. So as you can understand, with a U-shaped frame that's molded, you have a lot of torquing and twisting that could happen. And that was really the biggest challenge and concern from the beginning of the project. We did a lot of incremental design integration and engineering into the arm. We did a full FEA on those different design features and eventually came up with what we call a ripple leg. And it has opposing and ripple features or lattice internally to the leg that provide a design feature as well as structural integrity to the leg itself that, once it's molded, really helps with the rigidity of the part and maintain the alignment and flatness. Glass-filled polycarbonate, it's 30% glass-filled. We had started off with 10, went to 20, and then eventually to 30 because we felt the part could tolerate it, and it just added to the integrity of the part once it's shot. We have the covers that are creates a laminate, and we didn't want any screws shown on the outside because this was a very high-quality part, and we felt that the screws would really depreciate the value. So we designed little interfaces and bypasses with ribs internally that would get screwed into the chassis, the ripple leg, which again was really the money part in the whole assembly.